There were things going on at other areas of the Cape that also supported the launch or the ascent, but as far as getting the rocket off the ground, this is where it took place, and this is all the equipment that was required to get this rocket in the air. This is reflecting the state of the art of probably the late 1950s and early 1960s. The building that we are in is a literal fortress. The walls are 2.5 feet thick of reinforced concrete and steel, and the roof is 7.5 feet thick at the apex. The glass that you're looking through is 45 sheets, consists of 45 sheets of safety glass. All of this designed to protect the crew in case of a catastrophic failure outside. During a normal launch, you would not need a building of this reinforcement to survive the launch. But what you do need is a building like this if it would take a direct hit of a rocket going out of control, like we saw where that Juno got up about 100 feet and then went over on its side. Well, that very easily could have struck the launch control center. And the building had to be designed to withstand the maximum explosive force that one of these rockets could impart on a structure. And so that's why they're so heavily reinforced. Of all the equipment that you see in this room, there is not a single digital computer anywhere. There are a lot of vacuum tubes behind a lot of these consoles, but not a single digital computer. And I like to contrast that with our visitors to how we launch a space shuttle today. Because the crew to launch a missile from this room or a rocket from this room was about 15 to 20 individuals. And none of them with the aid of a computer. The computers were in the minds of their collective thought processes, and they were monitoring gauges and readings and deciding for themselves if this was acceptable and whether they were go or no-go for launch. Today, in order to launch a space shuttle, NASA does not have the budget to pay for an individual to monitor every single command, or the army of individuals it would take to monitor all of these commands and events that are critical to a space shuttle launch. And there are still hundreds of individuals that support a space shuttle launch as compared to a handful of individuals, probably no more than what we have in this tour group right here now, to launch one of these earlier rockets.